draw me close to you. Never let me go.
Give us the bread of life is Yahusua Ajimin. What do you say to her?
Amen.
One announcement. We will have a different meeting after church, so everyone will be seated after we all finish.
Whilst the God in Hap sings.
Nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We will now sing our hymn of meditation 463.
Gracious God, please take care of me as I'm going to preach to your church. In your
Amen.
Let me tell you a story. One day, there was a carer and a student. They were like shopping. While shopping, the student saw a shoe that he liked. Immediately, he told the carer, "Auntie, I like this shoe. Please buy it for me." Then he put it on, but unfortunately, it couldn't fit him. Then he told the carer, "Auntie, next time you see a smaller shoe, please buy it." Because of the confidence the kid had, the carer found a size shoe for him. What do you say to that?
Amen.
Now, we ask ourselves, how many times do we ask? Do we ask for something? If we were to be like that child, would we have the confidence to ask for something? Our Father says in heaven, "Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you'll find. Knock and it will be opened to you." I like this quote because how many times do we ask? Two? Once? Never. We have to ask. And if we have a problem, just tell the Father and he will solve it.
Amen.
The Bible says, "How come all you how are heavy loaded, and I'll give you rest." If you have a problem, talk to the Father and he will take away your burdens.
Mm-hmm.
And you
Amen.
Shall have and you shall have peace like that student.
Amen.
Now, at shopping centers, we see little kids jumping around, screaming. Why? Because they have peace. If we were to be like 46 and that, if we were doing that, people would call the cops. They'll be like, "Oh, this man is going crazy." But kids, they don't mind. Like me, my mom and dad, if they're paying my school fees, they're probably thinking, "Oh, the school's coming, we have to pay the school fees." If you're going to school, "Oh, school fees, I have to pay it." Just tell the Father, he will leave it, and he will solve it. Now, money. We think about money all the time, stress. "I need money." You're telling your friends, "I need your money. I need money." Everywhere where we go, we need money. But still, the Father is still there for us. If we need money, just tell him. We'll still solve it. Now, shall we take our Bibles and read the following verses? Can somebody read Luke 11:9?
"So I say to you, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will open to you."
Can somebody also read Matthew 21:22?
"If you believe, you will receive whatever you ask in prayer."
Can somebody read John 14:13?
"And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son." Amen.
Amen.
And Psalms 37:4.
"Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you what your heart desires." Amen.
Amen.
As you can see, all the Bible verses talks about what God has peace for us and how he wants us to share our problems with him. So my dear church, man can't give you peace. Telling people about your problems won't give you peace. If we have a problem, just tell the Father. Tell him all your worries, and he will give you peace to live. We will call Pastor to pray for the members that need peace here. Pastor Felix. And we will sing "I Must Tell Jesus."
Jesus, all of my trials.
bowed our heads. If there is something that is on your heart and you feel you must tell Jesus, you can tell him now. There are times we take that opportunity for granted, but our Father is always waiting to listen unto us. He is our peace. And I believe the Lord is here to take all our burdens away and to give us peace in the coming year. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for giving us these words of hope. We thank you so much that you are our peace and you are a Father. Sometimes our wrong understanding of how our earthly parents have been so much of caring, we think you are like that. There are times the wrong understanding we've had from our fathers affects the way we see you as a father. But you are a father that surpasses all human understanding. Therefore, you call us unto us to come, all those who are heavy laden, and that you will give us rest. We have carried so much burdens, thinking we can do it all by ourselves. There were times we thought we can do it by our strength, but the harder we try, the more we fail. Therefore, this morning, Father, we have come to you, that you who can re-lighten our burdens, may you help us. For some of us, we are sick and we don't know what to do even in the coming year. Father, may you grant us healing. For some of us, we are troubled by our family and marital issues. Father, we pray and plead that you will set in and give us peace. Some of us are praying for our kids. We brought them up in a way that were according to your will, but they have decided otherwise. Father, may you bring them back home. Amen. Some of us are praying for our families even back home in Ghana. May you please listen to our plea. Above all, Father, there is one thing that is on our hearts, that you keep our names in the Lamb's Book of Life. That if you are to appear anytime, whether we are alive or we are dead, we will still be called amongst the living to enjoy the eternal life you have for us. Father, we pray for this church, that as we set into this new year, with much hope to really become very vibrant and more useful in your ministry here in Sydney, may you empower us. May you enlighten us. May you make us the light that shines through the darkness. So we commit all our leadership into your care. That Father, you give them visions and dreams. Visions that are driven by your spirit and controlled by your will. May you continue to pull us together. In all our weaknesses, make us strong. In all our deficiencies, Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit. Amen. Now we pray for each and every one who has come here today, Father, especially for our friends who have visited us. There are many things probably they might have not got it, but I believe they know and they have got to know that in you there is neither Greek and there is no Jew. Father, may you bind our hearts together.
Amen.
And may you bless them. May you bless all of us as we continue to worship you in this Sabbath day. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit have we prayed with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen.
Draw me close to you. Never let me go. Lay it all down again to hear you say that I'm afraid. You are my destiny. To feel the warmth.